The following is a non-profit fan dub. The Adventure Zone is owned by the McElroys, Carrie Peach, and First Second Books. Links in the description to support the official Elise Brave Adventurers.
Settle yourself, boy. Dinner is almost ready. When the train passes, we shall eat.
My name's Taco. You probably recognize me.
From TV. Yes, I am familiar, sir.
So, what's the skinny, kid? You can level with me.
Like I said, I am the world's greatest detective.
Does your grandpa have anything to say about being braggy?
And I am on the trail of a serial killer named the Rockport Slayer.
Whoa, wait a sec. Serial killer? You're like 8. Shouldn't you be figuring out who stole the money from little Susie's lemonade stand?
I'm 10. The Rockport City Council wants me to track down the person who has been killing local wealthy individuals for the past few months. The Slayer murders them and steals their riches, and never leaves a trace. But I am going to stop this lunatic.
Yes, we will stop that lunatic.
We'll have to look at our suspect list.
I guess a trio of desperate hardasses like us are right at the top of that list. Huh, kid?
Oh no, sir. I am 100% sure that the three of you don't possess the competency required to perform multiple murders without getting caught.
Pretty solid observation.
He is a good detective.
However, the fact that you showed up posing as Lehman Kessler indicates that you're also looking for his killer. Or his treasure!
You told him there's a treasure?
I didn't say nothing about no treasure.
Why do you think there's a treasure?
That's the Rockport Slayer's M.O. He kills, then steals his victim's most valuable possession. And that's why you're on the train.
I think we're working toward a similar goal. The three of us work for an organization.
What organization? Fantasy CSI? Fantasy Shield? Fantasy Mall Cops?
The Bureau of Balance.
I couldn't quite catch that, sir.
Not this shit again.
I would be willing to bet that we also can't tell you that we're trying to recover a dangerous magical artifact.
Dangerous magical artifact? Got you loud and clear.
So there's this moon base, and dogs aren't allowed there.
Do those communication bracers prevent me from understanding what you're trying to say?
Sure, let's go with that.
Angus, here's what we can tell you. This item, if it falls into the wrong hands, is remarkably dangerous. It's incredibly bad. The body count for this Slayer person would increase from dozens to thousands in short order. We need to work together and figure this out now.
I agree. That's why I'm enlisting you to help me apprehend the Rockport Slayer, who must be somewhere on this train. If my suspicions are to be believed, the item you seek is inside the cargo car crypt safe.
Now you're just showboating, kid. That's where they lock stuff up on this train.
You didn't really, like, deduce the shit out of that one.
Duly noted, sirs. But I suspect it will require every one of my little gray cells to identify Rockport Slayer. We need to work quickly. The train will arrive in Eversummer in about 2 hours, at which time the Rockport Slayer will escape, and you three will be arrested.
We'll get arrested, but not you.
I'm the irresistibly cute 10-year-old detective. You're the suspicious-looking ne'er-do-wells who posed as a dead man and his posse.
Fair.
But that would go on my permanent record.
Well, that's...
Wookie.
Is that blood, sirs?
Okay, kid. You did the detective work. We'll do the heavy lifting.
Isn't this your cue?
Oh, yeah. Magnus rushes in!
God!
Does it have a bow tie? Tell me it doesn't have a bow tie!
No! Oh, Jenkins! Jenkins!
We should have appreciated you while you were alive!
If only you had used one of your spell slots to defend yourself!
Sirs?
Graham's dead too?
No, sir. He's not beheaded. Or behanded.
I've searched the body and there's no rod.
Man, that's nothing but dick jokes with us.
His rod. The teleport rod that powers the pressure chamber. It's not here.
The cut of the neck is very clean and precise. The cuts on the wrists are rougher. Not quite so surgical.
What happened?
We're not sure, but it kind of looks like you killed your buddy Jenkins. And cut off his hands and head.
That doesn't sound like me.
What do you remember, sir?
Horrible. Horrible!
Excuse me, sirs. You may want to step back. I'll help Mr. Graham get into the passenger car. You, sir, should run the other way towards the back of the train.
Don't worry about a thing, little man. We'll take care of this. Well, shoot.
I'm following Angus. I'll see you all in hell.
Wait, we can take this thing!
I didn't survive 10 years on the road by running toward things that wanted to kill me!
I know we don't have any weapons, but we've got magic!
Well, one of you does.
Hey! I want to tell you a story about the time someone sicked a big-ass mulching machine on me and I almost died. Or the time a guy wearing spider pajamas zapped me with magic missiles and I almost died. Or the time a giant dwarf doing a Burning Man imitation tried to kill me and I almost died. I'm not going toe-to-toe with a monster fire crab when Merle's armed only with a knockoff Gideon's Bible and Magnus doesn't even have his shield!
Did I say Magnus? I meant Leman Kessler.
I'm not Magnus, I'm Deadly.
I'm pretty sure I'm Leman Kessler.
Shut the door! What are you sirs doing? I told you to run towards the back of the train!
We wanted to, protect you?
You know what would have been a great way to protect me? To lead that monster anywhere but here, where all the people are!
Roll for initiative!
Time to do that cleric thing. Shield of faith! Shit!
And Taco takes 14 points of damage.
Wait, how many?
Oh, 14 is nothing. I shouldn't take 14 damage.
You should see a doctor. That doesn't sound normal.
Listen, you guys are level 4 now. You can take a beating.
How's this for level 4? Levitate!
Whammy!
Whoa, should I punch it again?
I would!
You should punch it again.
Ow, punch it again!
That was fucking radical!
Thank you. That is one tough crab.
Come on, let's finish it off!
Nah, I did my part.
What?
Yeah, did the floaty thing on the crab, almost died. I'm just gonna chill here.
Hey, don't worry. Everything's going to be okay. It's better not to split up your party.
Fine, I'll come.
I'm sure I didn't need all this blood anyway.
That crab's been busy.
First Barry Blue Jeans, now Jenkins? Our secondary characters sure do combust a lot.
No!
Not the drink cart!
My mojitos!
This time they've gone too far! The crab dies. Actually, he looks kinda cute floating up there.
Whee! Look at me! I'm an angry crab!
All right, Merle, you're up. What are you gonna do, little buddy?
I cast Word of Healing.
Healed for 11. Nice job.
Woo! Merle out.
Guys! That was our first moment of competence!
Holy crap, it was!
Nice!
I cast Rain of Scorching Oil! Didn't do much damage.
But it smells weirdly delicious.
So, basically, you invented a clarified butter spell.
My turn!
Well, let's see. You're skilled in carpentry. You probably have expertise in hitting enemies with chairs. Advantage. Magnus!
How is it still alive?
It is almost impossible to get rid of crabs.
Oh, yeah. I see what you did there.
Move!
Wow! Just crits for 29 points of damage.
Crab crit!
That was sweet as hell! You cut it right down to the wire! How'd you know exactly the coolest moment to jump in?
It looked like you guys had it handled. And I had a really bad initiative roll.
No, I just thought up some great crab puns.
Oh, me too!
Me three.
Oh, all right, you three scamps. Let it out.
That sure was a crusty crab.
We did a clawsome job.
Just was kind of shellfish killing it like that.
And we're done.
This episode of the Adventure Zone Comic Club is brought to you by Seafood Allergies. The Crab Bites Back.